Okay, so I ordered a box because I wanted to show you what it looks like when you unbox it.
Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry. I help you stop living in chaos, one organized space at a time. Today we are going into my guest bedroom here on the first floor. And the reason for that is I'm going to show you where I've stored my long-term drinking water. I live here in the desert, so it's a challenge to find a place in my home. I can't put it in the attic, I don't have a basement, and I can't put it in the garage or outside in the shed unless it's climate controlled. Well, I don't have that opportunity, so I had to find something or some place in my home where I could store the water.
So when you walk into my guest room, it looks like this. I do have a tour of my guest bedroom that I'll be sharing. You could check that out. Here to the left is the closet, and it's a double doors. So to the right is where my guests have, you know, stuff to hang their clothes and a luggage rack and stuff like that. And on the left is where I keep my water. So for now, this is what I have. And I've decided to get the bottled water ready to go, right? That type of water. And I put them in bins. And the reason I put them in bins is so that they could stack. If you just have these waters stacked on top of each other, four is probably the max, okay? And then once I use them, because sometimes I use them for, like, let's say we have to grab some, we have to put some for like a party. Like I had 60 people over here and just drinking from our Berkey was gonna be too much, or was not gonna be enough. So I just had bottled water, then I just replenish it. And then sometimes, so if all the whole bag is not used, they will be individual ones. So that's why I decided to put them to have bins, because then I can have the individual ones put in there and it still can be stacked, right? So here you can stack four, right? But it's sturdier versus if you're just stacking these on top of each other, because I've tried that and it was kind of like, you know, sketch. So that is good. That is working for me. So as far as when they're stacked up like this as a whole package or when they're individual, it's good to stack them. Now what happened was that I tried to put a fourth bin on top, and the bottom one, I think this one of those, just cracked the top of this bin. So it's just too much weight. I could do that and have a cracked bin at the bottom and it was still going to hold, but I just wanted it to be more secure. So what I'm doing is I'm waiting for, I'm trying to figure out if I should get like a sturdier shelf, have it built, have the one that goes on the wall, you know. So let me know in the comments below what's your suggestion for this, because you can see I have a lot of space to put more water. Okay, then on top, I actually really like this. So these are 3 gallons, okay, not 5 gallons. There are 3 gallons. They're about like $8.99 each, you know. They kind of had a, you know, a certain price range depending on when I bought them. And I get them at Walmart. I just order it online and I pick it up from the Walmart store. It's fantastic. And then I just filled it up with my Berkey water. So it takes time, you know, you have to fill up the Berkey water, and then when it gets to the point where it's all filtered, then I fill it in. And then when it gets a little bit too slow, you know, I fill up the Berkey again. And so it just takes time. It's not time that you don't have, you know. I made the time. And yeah, so I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I have 6 of them. Okay, and this one, oh, this one I still have to fill up, okay. I know what I did is I saved that one to film showing me filling it up. So maybe I'll show you that, okay. So, and this is pretty strong, you know. Now I didn't, you can stack these up to 3. Now I don't want to stack that, right? Cause it's like way up here now. But if it were on the ground, if it's something that you wanted to use on the ground, it could stack up 3. So I did try that first. I did have those down here at the bottom and I stacked them by 3 and they were 2 deep, right? 1, 2 rows deep. And I thought that would be great because then I could put 9, 3, 6, 9, 3, 6, 9, 18. But then I thought, where am I gonna put these bottled water? So it ended up that I can put these here. So another thing that I want to get your opinion on is, see how high the ceiling is? I mean, it goes up. I could stack one more and then there'd still be space on top. So I am waiting to see, maybe have somebody build another shelf like this, a heavy duty shelf, and then have something in front, you know, like a little ledge so that it won't fall over. Or maybe it has to be a higher ledge, but it has to be a ledge not too high where it's not easy to grab. Don't wanna hurt my arm, okay? So if you stand from here, you could see all the space, the water that can fit there. Now I did the calculation and I can't remember off the top of my head, but I think this is at least 3 months of water for the two of us. So it's, hold on, let me just calculate. Okay, so I calculated this is 62.5 gallons of water. I could add one more here to add another 5 gallons. So that'd be 67.5. All right, so 67.5 divided by three people, my husband, myself, and my daughter, if she comes back from the dorms from an emergency. Okay, that would be 22.5 gallons each, right? So that's 22.5 days of drinking water, which is a gallon per day. I mean, the FEMA only suggests 1 gallon of water, period, whether that's for cooking, cleaning, washing up, drinking, right? So this is good for drinking water. Okay, then under the bed, I have this rolling under the bin cart, and I think it's important that it's rolling and that it's also the plastic kind, not the fabric, because you want some structure to it when, or I want some structure to it when I'm holding the water in here. So I hope you can see that. And so I've had this forever. I used to have a lot more stuff in my house, and when I decluttered, I had these leftover bins, and I think it's great to declutter because then you can use it, that space that you've won back for more important things, like I'd say like prepping, like prepper stuff. Okay, so let me just open up the whole thing. So I just wanted to show you, like, you can have it if you don't have the closet space to put the bottled water like this, you could put it in an under bed storage. But I'm gonna go ahead and take this out. Just wanted it here to show you guys. And of course you have to get the water that's a little bit shorter. So you can see that this is the 10 full ounce. Because if you get the regular size, it's not gonna fit under the bed. I also did get these risers to lift up the bed a little bit because it was hard to push the storage underneath. I mean, it's fit, but it was always like, there's like friction. So I'll put a link in the description box below for those and everything else in this video. So if you don't have a guest room, maybe it's under your bed, maybe it's under your kid's bed, great place to store things. Here, I have this emergency drinking water, okay, from Datrix. So they have very good reviews. So my plan is to basically fill this with this type of water. And then I had this extra fabric bin that I just took it out of the box, put them in here. So they're easy to grab. Okay, so they're 4.227 full ounces, right? And these like store forever. Gosh, is it expiration date? You see that manufactured 10/2022, expiration 10/2027. So 5 years. So just make sure to use them up. You can use it for camping, for backpacking, hiking, you know, those type of day trips. And then I have this shoe box, another way you can store it. If you don't want that open bin, you can have a shoe box and cover it on top. So even maybe you have a shelf that you could stack a few of these shoe boxes with this emergency water in it, that would work. Okay. And then I wanted to show you, like, even if you have a huge bin like this and you throw the water in here, you don't have to have a shoe box. You don't have to have a fabric bin. You don't have to have a basket. You could just put them in like that. Okay. Okay. So I ordered a box because I wanted to show you what what it looks like when you unbox it. Because there's some reviews where it's like, oh, the water spilled everywhere, which I've been lucky. The ones that I have bought have not spilled. And luckily this one is all intact. So it just comes like that, all packed in. It's wonderful. Oh, look at all this awesome water. The other thing I have for water are these two little bins, and you can get more. These are stackable. I happened to get these at Ross randomly. It was in my son's apartment, so I have them now because he didn't need them anymore. And so what I've done is I've just taken these like liquid IV. They came in this packet, and I could just throw them in here, and you can see a lot more can fit. I also have the potable aqua water purification, and so you can see how even just one little bin like this can fit a whole lot of these tablets. And then Prime Day in July, I highly suggest this. I tried this Noon Sport Hydration. That's the one I like. They have other, like, you know, Noon Hydration, not the necessarily the sport one. And I bought a whole bunch, and if I counted right, I bought 46 of these tubes, and they came out to $196, including tax. So it was Prime Day, so it was like originally $267, then $86 off, and so it ended up being $196.10, I think, was the exact price. So these are the citrus fruit, and I've been using them every day since July. I mean, it's been like 4.5 almost 5 months, and they've lasted. So I have these two left, and I wanted to buy a whole bunch and then see how long it lasted, so that I will probably buy again. Of course, Prime Day in July is not till next year, but I'll probably buy double of what I got. If this lasts me 6 months, then I'll buy double, because it's definitely a better price. And then these bins you could either put in that big container, you could just put it directly underneath the bed, in a cabinet, on a shelf, in a bigger bin, you know, so it just kind of separates what type of emergency water you have. All right, I have one more of these, but it does fit directly under my bed, so I'll just use it for that, and versus putting it in this bin. Okay, all done with that. Then I'm just going to push it underneath the bed. So there's a lot of space for more water. I just want to put it on the rug. Okay, there.
I also want to mention that I do have a water bomb, and I do have other water that's more for cleaning, not drinking, and I store those a different way. And I have the, you know, the portable water filtration or drinking straws.
Okay, so I'm going to take those smaller bottles of water and go ahead and put them in this bin. And again, that bin is the one that I use for loose bottled water. The reason why you want to keep it intact like this, if you have to bug out, you can just grab it, the whole thing like this, or you can just grab the whole bin like that and stick it in the back of your car. Then you have your bug out bags. You can also grab one of those things of the emergency water. Even these, you can grab them and go. This is how I store my water. Still more to go. Hope you enjoyed. Click the next video for more organizing, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.